This is JSA TV and JSA Podcast, the newsroom for telecom and data center operators. I'm Dean Perrine, EVP at JSA. We are coming at you on location from Metro Connect 2020 in beautiful Miami, Florida. And I'm here with my old friend, Mr. Bob DeSantis. Bob is the CEO. We're friends now. Thank you, Bob. Bob is the CEO of 365 Data Centers. Bob, welcome to JSA TV, as always.
Well, thank you, Dean. Nice to be back again.
All right. So, Bob, big year for you in 2019, and that momentum has really carried into 2020. Mm-hmm. Why don't you give our viewers a recap of what's happened for 365 in 2019?
Happy to do that. Well, you know, we entered, Dean, 2019 after, in 2018, successfully integrating a platform business that we had acquired in 17, along with an add-on acquisition, and went even further than just successfully integrating the businesses. We expanded the network quite extensively between and among our data centers and points of presence, and made quite an investment in our cloud platform. So it positioned us very well to come into 2019 to start scaling the business now that we had a good platform. And so I'd say the first milestone for us in 2019 was a refinancing of our business with a group of lenders that are, you know, three of the top lenders in the data center and network, industry. And by doing so, we certainly lowered our, you know, debt service costs by quite a bit, and provided for quite a bit of growth capital for future growth and acquisitions that we expected to come. Later in the year, in August, we brought in the fourth equity partner to join my two existing equity partners and myself to provide us with further growth capital. So having that growth capital committed in September, we closed on a very nice acquisition strategically located for us in New Jersey, about a 25,000 square foot data center with a little over 2.5 megawatts of power and over 130 enterprise customers, and very strategically located between our Philadelphia and New York City data centers. And just recently, something we had hoped to announce at the end of last year, but took a little longer, but was well worth it. We acquired our 12th data center in Long Island, New York, from a company called Mindshift, which works way up the cloud stack in providing services to its customers. And that is our flagship data center at this point. Again, another 25,000 square feet of data center space, some 6 megawatts of power will allow us to do very high density, customer servicing, and continues that a very nice string, along the East Coast, you know, regarding our strategy. So we've been pretty busy since last year.
It sounds that way. So Bob, why don't you tell our viewers a little bit about how those acquisitions ultimately are going to be benefiting your customers in the Northeast?
Well, I really think, Dean, they're going to benefit our customers, you know, across the whole East Coast, but particularly in the Northeast. We acquired one particular set of customers with our New Jersey transaction who had only been offered by the previous provider limited services. Now those customers can certainly not only buy data center colocation services, but network services and, you know, including IP transit and network access and transport to our other data centers, certainly can buy virtual services from us. So it allows them with one provider to serve more of their IT needs. With regard to our customers outside of New Jersey and Long Island, they now have access into New Jersey, into other parts of New York. And, so whether it's, having disaster recovery or having production with us, it just provides us with more geographic diversity. And of course, you know, in the Northeast, which is so data intensive, yeah, having a string of data centers now from Philadelphia up through Central Jersey into New York City, out to Long Island and up to Buffalo, New York, gives us a very nice Northeast presence for customers, not only in that region, but outside the region who would like to have some location of their services in the Northeast.
Excellent, Bob. Thank you. So the momentum doesn't appear to be stemming at this point. Why don't you tell our viewers a little bit about what they can expect in 2020?
Well, I think we like to look at it on a twofold basis. We're putting a big investment into our sales staff this year. Obviously, we have some new locations that we want to make sure we're interfacing well with the enterprise customers. So we need to do that. Adding more capability into our network and virtual headcount to support us on those fronts. Certainly with the funding that we have available to us, we're not done on the acquisition front. And that
was my real question right there.
Okay. Fair enough. We're constantly looking at opportunities, but, you know, we're very disciplined buyers. And, you know, what that means, we really only focus on businesses that fit our East Coast strategy, number one. You know, have a product set that complements well with our existing product set, where we can get extensions from it, or, you know, more resiliency in what we're offering, and, you know, very, very disciplined in terms of our purchase prices and what we're willing to pay as a multiple for these businesses. So, we always have that opportunity, and, you know, having a very scalable business still, we're not done, I don't think, on the acquisition front. There's a lot more we can tuck in the Northeast quadrant of the U.S. and certainly with our great presence in Florida, more we can do down here. And why not?
Absolutely.
Why not be here in Florida? Right?
Absolutely. Bob, thank you very much for being with us. We really appreciate it.
Thanks,
and thank you, viewers, for watching JSA TV and listening to JSA Podcast. We'll see you soon, and happy networking.